الرحمن الرحيم بالله الذي لا يضر عن به شيء في الارض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بالله بجريها وقصاها الى ربي لغفور رحيم بسم الله وبالله ومن الله وعلى الله وفي الله ولا حول ولا قوه الا بالله العلي العظيم الله اكبر 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 كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله العظيم وتعالى بكرة وأصيلا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا وحبيبنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك وأكرِم وأنعِم وتفضل على سيدنا وحبيبنا ونبينا وشفيعنا ومولانا محمد بصلاة لم يصلي بمثلها مخلوق صلاة تجل عن الصلوات تفوق صلاة المصلين عليه في الأرضين والسماوات ننفرد بها في الدنيا ونفوز بها بعد الممات صلاة تقربنا بها منك إليك اجعلنا بها يا ربنا من أقرب الأقربين إليك ومن أحب المحبوبين لديك يا رب العالمين وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا عدد خلقك ورضاء نفسك وزنة عرشك ومداد كلماتك في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسع علمك يا الله يا حي يا قيوم يا من تنام العيون وتنكدر النجوم أنت حي قيوم لا تأخذك سنة ولا نوم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام My dear brothers and sisters in Iman الحمد لله الحمد لله على صيام رمضان والحمد لله على التوفيق من رب العزة جل جلاله على قيامه وتلاوة القرآن. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for allowing us to fast during the month of Ramadan. It was not our choice that we will fast Ramadan, but it was the determination of the Lord Almighty Allah who has allowed us to fast during the month of Ramadan. Hence Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is reported that when Rajab used to enter, he will pray and say, اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان. Oh Allah, bless the months of Rajab and Sha'ban for us and allow us to live during the months of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, we are here today and it is the day of Eid. That means Allah has permitted us to fast during the month of Ramadan. Have we remembered to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Have we remembered to say to Him, لك الحمد والشكر يا الله. All praises and thanks are due to you, O Allah, for giving us the chance to fast during the month of Ramadan. And the idea is, Ramadan is not any month. It's a very special month. A month in which the word of Allah Almighty God, the old word, was revealed to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The word that, in the sight of Allah, in the highest position, is the most exalted wealth. Allah says about it in the Quran, وَإِنَّهُ لَدَيْنَا فِي أُمُّ الْكِتَابِ لَعَلِيٌّ حَكِيمٌ If only you know that this Holy Quran you recite, in the mother of the books, the mother of the book is the protected tablet, اللوحة المحفوظ. في اللوحة المحفوظ, لَعَلِيٌّ حَكِيمٌ The most exalted, the most high. The Quran is nothing but something very special that people need to think about. We thank Allah for coming in Ramadan to listen to the imams all over the world, and may Allah bless them all, reciting the Quran for us in the Taraweeh prayer. And therefore, this month is a very special month, Ramadan. We are sad to see it going. We are very sad that Ramadan has gone, and we are beginning a new life while Allah will shut all the doors of the heavens, and all the doors of the hell will be open. And all the shayateen and the afarit, including Iblis and the shayateen of the human beings and the shayateen of the jinn, will be let loose. And may Allah help us if we have not managed to achieve that which Allah wanted us to achieve in Ramadan. What did Allah want us to achieve in Ramadan? He said in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون Oh you who believe, indeed fasting has been prescribed for you as it was prescribed for those before you, perhaps, or maybe you achieve piety.
And therefore, if we have not achieved piety by today, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us the way to the next Ramadan, when the time will come for us to indulge in what Allah prescribed to Rasulullah sallam, whereby the beginning of Ramadan will be a shower of mercy. The middle of Ramadan will be an ocean of forgiveness from Allah Almighty God. A repentance into Him will be the pleasure. And the end of it, if we are lucky enough to be struck off from the book of those people who are determined to go to the hellfire. رمضان أوله رحمة وأوسطه مغفرة وآخره عتق من النيران. هذا قول النبي الكريم صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم. He صلى الله عليه وسلم says, Ramadan, it is beginning is mercy, it is middle is forgiveness, it is end is salvation from the hellfire. Now we hope that Allah has showered us with mercy and forgive our sin, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken away our name from the book of those people who are definitely entering the hellfire. For we don't know what is going to happen in the day of judgment. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. The day where nobody will be benefiting from anything you accumulate in this world. Your children will be of no value to you. And your wealth definitely will be of nothing that will bring you benefit in the day of judgment. Only a pure, clean heart. Only a pure, clean heart, which Allah has chosen for it to be determined in the month of Ramadan. Ramadan Shahru Taqwa, or Ramadan is the month of nurturing and bringing up ourselves, our egos, and restraining ourselves. صوموا فإنه لكم وجاء قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. He صلى الله عليه وسلم said, do fast, for it is self-restraining. We need to learn how to restrain ourselves from the evil characters that we have, such as anger, such as being jealous and envious, such as being greedy and self-centered, such as being selfish and wicked. And let me tell you, in a world we live in today, how many people we see who are in such position. Too many people. Look at the Arab world, leaders whom Allah has chosen and given positions. What have they done for themselves? Forget about what they have done for their ummah. What they have done for themselves. Where are they going to stand before Allah? How are they going to answer Allah Almighty God? Are they going to beg Him and ask Him to be retained to the world for 1 year? What are they going to say to them? Or to say to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have ruled our people for such a time and we did everything. They have not done anything that we'll be proud of. They have taken away the people for a ride, and they have done that which is most evil. But Allah Almighty God, يُمْهِلْ وَلَا يُهْمِلْ. He will delay, but never neglect. For there are those people who have been wronged. May Allah help all the Muslims who have been oppressed. And may Allah help all the Muslims who have not been given a chance. And all those Muslims who are striving to do good, just to say, La ilaha illallah. How many times we hear in the news in our Muslim countries, people are only killed because they go to the mosque, or have a circle to study about the Quran, or go out to remind people about Islam. The slogan that the shaitan has used and the shayateen against the ummah, our leaders, some of them, not all of them, but some of them have been using. May Allah guide us and guide them. And may Allah give us tawfiq to understand and appreciate that in this month of Ramadan is the biggest chance so that we can straighten ourselves. إن النفس لأمارة بالسوء. Indeed, one nafs will always command him or her to do evil, all the time. But Ramadan, as Allah says, الصوم لي وأنا أجزي به. Fasting is for me and I am alone with reward for it. Everything else you do is written in your book by Raqib. But Ramadan and the fasting generally is written in a book with Allah. Allah said, it is for me and I am alone will reward you for it. When they bring everything you have done before Allah in the Day of Judgment, and imagine if you have failed, Allah will say, have he any of the fasting that he has done that we can see? And if you had, you will be very lucky. It will be brought forth and it will be measured. Unlucky are those who will have one day they have fasted for the sake of Allah. For Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was reported to say, a fasting of one day for the sake of Allah, and Allah accepts, it will remove you from the path of the hellfire like the distance between the east and the west. And Allah described those people who will not see the hellfire in the day of judgment as the closest to Him. Allah said about them, لَا يَسْمَعُونَ حَسِيسَهَا وَهُمْ فِي مَشْتَهَتْ أَنفُسَهُمْ خَالِدُونَ. They will not hear the sound of the hellfire but they will be indulged in that which they desire, enjoying themselves. This is what we need to think about. What have we prepared for the Day of Judgment? Allah said in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وتزودوا فإن خير الزاد التقوى واتقوني يا أولي الألباب. And do take provision, O you people of understanding. And do fear me. And do understand my position before you. Don't make Allah's position in the lowest in your eyes. And make the people position higher than Allah. Some might ask, how can I put Allah lower than people? We do. When we are walking in public, when we are seen by the people we love, we hide the wrong we do. We don't do that which is haram in front of them. When we go to our home and shut our doors and close our curtains and do that which Allah dislikes, then that is the time when we put Allah beneath the makhluk, beneath the created being. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Almighty Allah, the greatest. Allahu Akbar Kabira. Allah is the greatest of all. None will benefit from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until you see him in his right position. He is the Almighty Allah, Jalla Jalaluhu, who have created you and made you and fashioned you fi ahsani taqweem, in the best way possible. Respect yourself. Go out of this mosque today and remember, Eid day is not about wearing new clothes. Eid day is not about having a lot of food. Eid day is not even giving your sadaqah to the poor people. But Eid day is realizing that you have achieved the acceptance of Allah, and that mercy has been poured into your heart, and that your sin have been forgiven, and that your name has been struck off the book of the hellfire. And that today you walk light, and you will do that which utmost easily to do by those people who are accepted, but most difficult for those who are not accepted. What is it? It's to forgive. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا. Command them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that they will forgive and make up with people. I want you to leave this mosque. If anybody has wronged you, go to them and forgive them. Especially if this person is close to you. Many people don't understand, when you have difficulty with your mother and your father, you are only putting an obstacle between you and the heavens and the door to paradise. Al-jannatu wal-walidayn awsatu abu-al-jannah. The Prophet ﷺ said, the parents are the middle door of paradise. If you have any difficulty with your parents, Allah is my witness. If they are alive, go to them. If they are easy to reach, go to them. Kiss their hand, their forehead, kiss their feet. Wash the feet of your mother, and you will still not be able to reward her for what she has done for you. She carried you for 9 months. She bore you while she is suffering. Many of them died in this world, your mothers. And she look after you until you are an adult and until you go to your grave. Are we thinking about our mothers? Are we thinking about our fathers? Are we calling them? You might say, they don't live with me. But you can call them. Today, communication is very easy. Keep link with your parents. Keep link with your mother and father. Be all the time there, kind to them as they were kind to you. Don't raise your voice to them. Don't even say oof to them. وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍ وَلَا تَنْهَرُهُمَا وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. Do not raise your voice. Do not say even oof to them, but say good, kind word to them. I have advice, and Allah is my witness, so he hears me. If you have any difficulty with your parents, you have no eid until you make up with them. Number two, you need to make sure that your brothers and your sisters, your uncles and your aunties, your cousins, your nephews, your nieces, your grandparents, your relation, even distance. And let me tell you, even your neighbors. Some will ask me, I'm living in England, I'm living in London, my neighbors are not Muslims. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was taught by the most highest, Allah Almighty God, that you should always respect your neighbors. You should love them. من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليكرم جاره. Whosoever believe in Allah on the last day must be generous to their neighbors. Your neighbors are any neighbors. Be good to them today. Maybe your smile will make them feel Islam is good. Maybe your shaking hand with them take away the ills in their hearts. Because Rasulullah said in the hadith, تصافحوا تعانقوا فإنه مذهب عنكم الغل. Do shake hands, embrace one another. It will remove illness from the heart. Carry no grudges against anybody. Have no enemies but Iblis. For Allah Almighty, my Lord and your Lord, instructed you in the Quran, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ كَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ فَاتَّخِذُهُ عَدُوًا. Indeed, Shaytan was an enemy for you. You must take him alone as an enemy. Your father, your mother, your relations, generally, people, generally, whoever they are not your enemies. They are the people. Most of us sitting here are coming from nations which are Muslims. Most of us were living in a situation which is miserable. Most of us created a way to come here even lying and cheating because they know there is peace here. And therefore, we must bring peace into this land. And only peace can come by Allah Almighty because Allah is peace. Allahumma anta salam wa minka salam wa ilayka yarji'u salam fa hayyina ya rabbana bis salam wa adkhilna al janna daraka dar as salam tabarakta wa ta'alayta ya dhal jalali wal ikram. Oh Allah, you are the peace. From you come the peace, to you retain the peace. Greet us with your greeting of peace when we meet you in the day of judgment, and allow us with your permission to enter your garden, the garden of peace. This is the advice of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. After every salah you must read it to remind yourself. But we don't have time. We are busy gathering the dunya, gathering the world. The imam, if he delayed the prayer for a minute to allow people to come, there are some who will rush him. Please, we have dunya to rush to. We have work to go to. Please don't be among those people who do that. Rasulullah sallallahu used to rush to come early to the salah and leave late because he will sit and seek forgiveness and ask for peace and ask for mercy. The ummah is big today because the mosques are empty. You might see it in Eid day full, but believe me, these beautiful monuments are empty. We are building hundreds of mosques in this country. When we arrived into this land, London has only one purpose-built mosque. Today there are over 80 mosques. There are over 400 or 500 musallas even in the prisons. But shameful, the Muslim community should think why there are too many mosques in the prisons, because quarter of the population of the prisons are Muslims. From the age of 21 to 24. May Allah guard them, may Allah save them, may Allah bring them out, may Allah guide them, and may Allah guide us to guide them. They are our children. If we leave them, they will go astray. In this day of Eid, we should pray for them. If they are there in prison, our children, our relation, our friend should go and visit them and remind them. فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah said in the Quran, remind for the reminder will be good for those who believe. And I will ask of you, please, when you leave this mosque to go back to your home, don't come with the same route you came. Take a different route. For the malaika who have registered your name when you are coming, it will be good for you in that book they have written your name into. Let other angels write your name into their books. So you will have too many angels writing your name in their books. In the day of judgment, it will be fantastic for you. In the day of Eid, my brothers and sisters, when we leave from here to go to our homes, the best thing we can do is to buy our families some gifts, a small gift, even something to eat. Even buying one rose, one flower to your wife, to your mother, to your daughter, to your sister. Many Muslims think, well, it is a waste of money buying flowers. My question to those people who say that, why did Allah create them? If it is not for those women whom Allah has created, they can enjoy them. It's not haram, not because of the Western that they do it. It is for us, the believers, to enjoy doing that. We need to understand our religion. We need to respect our Prophet, and we need to act upon his teaching. For he indeed, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, says, تَرَكْتُ فِيكُمْ أَثْنَانِ إِن تَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِهِنَّ فَلَنْ تَضِلُّ. I have left for you two things. If you hold tight unto them, you will never go astray. كِتَابُ اللَّهِ وَسُنَّتِي وَفِي رِوَايَةٍ عِتْرَتِي. The book of Allah and my way of living. And in another riwayah, the book of Allah and my family. My family. And let me remind you of the family of Rasulullah sallam. Those who have come from Fatima and Ali ibn Abi Talib, wal-Hasan wal-Husayn, wal-Hamza wal-Abbas. This is the greater family of Rasulullah sallam. We must look after them. We must care for them. Many people think today there is no family of the Prophet sallam. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. People can relate themselves to Adam today if they have the ability to look back. Our ancestors registers our tree. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have his family tree. And it is one of the noblest tree. And you must believe it is the right tree. Otherwise, there is a doubt in your face. How come Rasulullah sallam and the Prophet and the good people have family trees? And we don't have, we should all have family trees. But because of our neglect, our ignorance, we have not learned anything. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came 1400 years ago and said, ta'allamu al-ilma wa'allimuhu al-nas. Go out and seek knowledge and learn knowledge and teach people. And therefore our ancestors were the greatest in the world. They managed to take Islam within 10 years to all corners of the world. And he said, man ta'allamu al-ilma wa'allimuhu al-nas. وَخَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْعِلْمَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. And the best of you is the one who learn knowledge and teaches it. In another riwayah, in another narration, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. The best of you is the one who learn the Quran and teaches it. Teach your children. If your children are learning normal knowledge, it is good. If they are learning Islam, it is better. If they are learning the Quran, it is even better. And if they are learning everything, it's the best thing. Don't stop anybody from learning. This is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to bring. إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ مُعَلِّمًا. I was only sent as a teacher, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at the teacher in our community today. The lowest of the low is the teacher. Nobody look after the teacher. If your door is knocked and somebody is asking for your daughter, you are asking what job you do. Are you a doctor? Are you a dentist? Are you a sergeant? Are you a captain in an army? What job? Are you a rich businessman? But when you say you are a teacher, you are an officer in an office, when you are unemployed, nobody look at you. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. Where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تَذَوَّجُوا فُغْرَى يُغْنِيكُمُ اللَّهِ. Marry when you are poor, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you rich. Therefore, my sisters and brothers, Allah is listening to me and listening to you. Allah is ever watching us. We must take the message of the deen properly. Let us live Islam in this land the right way. We are grateful to Allah we are in this land. We thank Allah we are here. For Allah has given us an opportunity to practice our deen. To build the monument of the deen in this land, whereby if you came about 50 years ago, there was nothing. Even 25, 30 years ago, there was very little. But today, alhamdulillah, many of you have a position with Allah because you have managed to help the people of this land to understand the message of Islam. My last message for you is never, never, never give anything to those people who are outside but the best of the deen. And the best of the deen in the manner and the conduct and the behavior that you have achieved during the fasting of Ramadan. خَيْرُ النَّاسِ أَحَاسِنَهُمْ أَخْلَاقًا. The Prophet said the best of mankind or the best of people are those who are well behaved, those who have the best character. Salah lead to a good character. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. Salah forbid all acts of evil. Sawm, fasting, allow you to achieve piety. Hajj teach you to be patient and tolerant. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us those acts of worship so that we can be good. And when we pay zakah or give charity, we remove from our heart selfishness and being jealous and envious. Because those who give, they are never jealous nor envious. May Allah guide me and guide you. May Allah strengthen me and strengthen you. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. أستغفر الله العظيم وتوب إلى الله من كل ذنب ومن كل محسن ومن كل خطيئة كل ما يخالف دين ثمتنا عليك يا رب من كل شر. الحمد لله. الحمد لله الذي لا إله إلا هو الواحد الغفار. الحمد لله الذي لا إله إلا هو الواحد الجبار. الحمد لله الذي لا إله إلا هو الواحد الستار. الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله العظيم وتعالى بكرة واصيلا. My dear brothers and sisters in Iman, we do salute our messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا نبي الله. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا حبيب الله. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا إمام المرسلين. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا خاتم النبيين. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا شفيع المذنبين. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا خير خلق الله أجمعين. ألف صلاة وألف سلام عليك وعلى آل بيتك أجمعين. And we do salute آل بيته, all the family of the Prophet وسلم, and all those people who have strived since the time of the companion and the tabi'in, and those who followed them to our time in nourishing the ummah from the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What have we learned from Ramadan? Have we learned from Ramadan that awwaluhu rahma, it is beginning with mercy, so that we can come out and be merciful to people? Please, if you are harsh with your family, leave this mosque today and be kind to your family. If you used to raise your voice to your children or hit them or smack them, it's not the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never hit any of his children or his wives. I will challenge any human being to prove that Rasulullah sallam ever struck anybody with his hand. ما ضرب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أحدا قط إلا في معركة خاضها. He صلى الله عليه وسلم never hit anybody. Never. Only in a battle he fought to defend himself. عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام. Take the teaching of the Prophet. Follow the sunnah of the Prophet. قد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر. Indeed, in the messenger of Allah, you have the best example, alayhi abdul salatu wasalam. But this is only for the one who want Allah. Do you want Allah? Only for the one who want the hereafter. Do you want the hereafter? If you want Allah and you want the hereafter, follow the Prophet, not just by dressing, not just by the way you eat or what you accumulate. The Prophet used to love this, I'm loving it. The Prophet used to wear that, I'm wearing it. No, by your character. Behave well, Be good to your children. خيركم خيرهم لأهله. The best of you is the one who is best to his family. وأنا خيركم لأهلي. And I am the best to my family. هذا قول النبي الحبيب المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. شفيع الأمم. He صلى الله عليه وسلم will not just stand for us in the day of judgment, but all the people. All the people will be there for him, and he will be there for them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I would like you also to be good to those you employ. If you have got a company or a shop or a business, or even in your house, you employ a gardener, you employ somebody to come and clean your house, please be good to them. Please be kind to them. When they are working, don't push them hard. When they are working, while they are working and they are sweating, let them have a rest. Give them water, give them food to eat, give them drink. كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خير الناس. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم خيركم خيركم لأهلي. The best of you is the one for best, who is best to his family. And therefore this worker you should consider as one of your family because he is serving you. وخير الناس من ينفع الناس. And the best of mankind is the one who bring benefit to mankind. So please look after those people whom you employ. And if you are employed by anybody, don't take advantage, a lie, a ring. How many people sometimes ring and tell their employer where they're coughing, I'm not really feeling very well today, while they're feeling healthy, while they're going to the airport to do a chore or to go and do something. In our religion, we don't lie, we don't cheat. And when we go and do a job, we do it properly. مَنْ عَمَلَ مِنْكُمْ عَمَلًا فَلْيُتْقِنُهُ. Whosoever does any work from you must do it well. As an employer or employee, we must always fear Allah. وَاتَّقُونِ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. O you men and women of understanding, listen to Allah saying to you in the Quran, you must fear me if you have an understanding. Fear Allah if you have an understanding, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide you. Please let me remind you, in Eid Day, we have a lot of people who are suffering. In Somalia, in Afghanistan, in Sudan, in many other countries in Asia and South America. And there are many charities who are gathering funds. Your Sadaqatul Fitr is only £5 per head or £4 in some areas. That's not really a lot of money. Please, as much as you can, be generous today. As generous as you can, give support. If you come from Somalia or from Sudan, Eritrea, or you come from Pakistan, Afghanistan, Iraq, and you know people there, ring them and tell them to give on your behalf, because there are people today who will not have Eid because they will have no parents. They have perished. May Allah help the people in Libya. May Allah help the people in Syria. May Allah help the people in Afghanistan and Iraq and all those places where children today, they have nobody to wipe away their tears. But we can wipe their tears by helping them. Who is there for the orphan? Who is there for the widow? Who is there for the man who have lost his limb and have nobody to look after him? Who is there for the one who has been tortured at this moment in a cell somewhere underground in a Muslim country? May Allah help us. May Allah gather us together in one side. Allah said, وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا وَيَذْهَبُوا رِيحُكُمْ. Do not dispute within another. Do not fight one another. Therefore Allah will take your faith from your heart and you will then be a failure. May Allah take away this from us and make us among the most successful people. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. يا ربنا لك الحمد والشكر. يا ربنا لك الحمد والشكر. يا ربنا لك الحمد والشكر. كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. حمدا كثيرا طيبا جزيلا دائما ابدا مع خلودك يا كريم. جزا الله عنا سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ما هو أهله. جزا الله عنا سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ما هو أهله. جزا الله عنا سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ما هو أهله. جزا الله عنا والدينا خير الجزاء. جزا الله عنا معلمينا خير الجزاء. جزا الله عنا مشايخنا خير الجزاء. نسألك اللهم يا الله 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 يا رحمن يا رحيم يا رحمن الدنيا ويا رحيم الآخرة يا مفتح الأبواب يا مسبب الأسباب يا حنان يا منان يا ديان يا سبحان يا سلطان يا إيمان يا إحسان يا عظيم الشان يا هو يا حاضر يا من لا يغيب يا مجيب يا قريب يا سميع يا بصير يا سريع الوحى الوحى العجل العجل الإجابة الإجابة أجب دعوتي واقض حاجتي يا مجيب الدعوات يا قاضي الحاجات يا عالم السر والخفيات بأهيا شرعه يا أودنا يسبعوت يا مجلع عظائم الأمور يا من لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم يا أول يا آخر يا ظاهر يا باطن يا محيط يا جامع يا من ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير حون قاف ندم حمهاء أمين أنت ربي يا الله يا قادر يا قدير يا مقتدر يا جاعل يا آمر يا مسبب يا من تقول للشيء كن فيكون اللهم يا سببي إذا ما تقطعت الأسباب ويا رجائي إذا ما غلقت الأبواب ويا أنسي تحت طبقات التراب أسألك اللهم بالركن الأيمن وبالمحراب سر فاتحة الكتاب يا الله يا عزيز يا كريم يا وهاب يا الله يا عزيز يا كريم يا وهاب يا الله يا عزيز يا كريم يا وهاب يا جليس الذاكرين يا أنيس المنقطعين يا من أنت في قلوب المنكسرين يا أرحم الراحمين يا أكرم الأكرمين يا خير الرازقين يا رب العالمين يا رب العرش العظيم يا رب الناس يا ملك الناس يا إله الناس يا إلهنا وإله كل شيء إله واحدة لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين اغفر اللهم لنا ولوالدينا ولمشايخنا ولمن علمنا ولمن له حق علينا وللسائل والمحروم ولكافة المسلمين أجمعين اللهم ربنا اشفنا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اغفر اللهم لنا ولموتانا وموتى المسلمين وانصر اللهم الإسلام والمسلمين إخواننا المسلمين المستضعفين في كل مكان خاصة في ليبيا وسوريا واليمن اللهم يا رب أيدهم اللهم يا رب انصرهم اللهم يا رب وفقهم يا رب بدل أحوالهم إلى أحسن حال وولي أمورهم خيارهم ولا تولي أمورهم شرارهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم رب كن لنا ولا تكن علينا وانظر اللهم إلينا بعين الرحمة وحين حياة السعداء ومتنا متة الشهداء وحين يا ربنا يوم القيامة بذمة الأمناء والشهداء والصالحين والأنبياء والمرسلين وأوردنا حوض نبيك المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم واسقنا اللهم منه شربة لا نضمع بعدها أبدا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا اجعلنا من جندك فإن جندك هم الغالبون ربنا اجعلنا من حزبك فإن حزبك هم المفلحون اللهم يا رب اجعلنا من أوليائك فإن أوليائك لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون اللهم رب اجعلنا من عبيدك الذين إذا نظرت إليهم ذكر غضبك يا كريم اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا وقلبا خاشعا ونورا ساطعا ورزقا واسعا وشفاء من كل داء والغنى عن الناس يا رب اشرح صدورنا يسر أمورنا افتح اللهم علينا فتوح العارفين العاشقين اللهم رب اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت بارك اللهم لنا فيما أعطيت غنى اللهم شر ما قضيت إنك تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك تباركت ربنا وتعاليت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام اللهم إنا نسألك سلطانا نصيرا وحظا عظيما وأجرا وفيرا وتجارة لن تبور وفقنا اللهم توفيقا مطلقا وارزقنا حلالا طيبا واسعا بلا كد استجب اللهم دعاءنا بلا رد وآتنا اللهم كلمة لا ترد وادخلنا اللهم الجنة بغير حساب إنك أنت الله العزيز الكريم الوهاب ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا يا مقلب القلوب والأبصار ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم رب أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وطاعتك وحسن عبادتك اللهم رب نجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مباركا مرحوما واجعل اللهم تفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ما فينا ولا معنا ولا منا شقينا ولا محروما أي أسك الله سبحانه وتعالى for everyone whatever they intend whatever they have in their heart may Allah fulfill for them and may Allah take us out of this mosque where full of mercy. Allah has forgiven our sin. And Allah has written us from the people who are entering paradise. Wa salli Allahumma ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammadin wa sallim tasliman kathira. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wa salamun ala al-mursaleen. Wa alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Al-Fatiha. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Ar-Rahmanirrahim. Maliki yawmiddin. Iyaka na'bud wa iyaka nasta'in. Ihdina sirata al-mustaqim. Sirata al-ladhina an'amta alayhim. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين كل عام وأنتم بخير والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته